Hi guys, I am Jolt from the Freezing Moon, and in this tutorial I will show you how to create a table or desk like this. As you can see, it's a pretty modern looking thing, and it uses only two materials, a plastic one and of course the glass one going in the middle. I wanted to do it from glass because it looks better, and yeah, I like the idea that you can see through the top part and you can see what's in the middle, because in the finished result I will have this part here flattened out, so it can be used as a holder, so you can have things on it, so you can put your glasses of water or whatever on it, as well as on the top. But enough about that. Let me show you something quickly. I have a material.blend file prepared for this tutorial, so you don't really have to bother with the composition setup, the materials and the lighting, because I have saved all of those in this blend file, and you only have to link these things into your scene. Okay, let's start. We are going to use this basic cube, and for that we are going to step into edit mode by pressing tab, move the cube up a little bit and scale it down. This will be the glass material, so it shouldn't be too thick, but it shouldn't be too thin as well. I think that this should do it. And let's start shaping it. I will bring it down just like that, and let's shape the S shape I've done for the previous version. Okay, bringing it here, and I'm going to show you a nice little trick to make this line perfectly aligned with the top line, and this here. We can scale these along the x-axis, I think, yeah, right, and it will correct the shapes and the lines, so they will be perfectly lined up with each other. Okay, let's pull this all the way to this side, and I will move the overall shape down a little bit. Let's curve it backwards, and this part will create one of the feet, or the one of the sides of the desk, which is actually on the ground. Alright, this should do it. As you can see, it's quite choppy and flat, and to make it a bit more polished, first of all we are going to use smooth shading, and after that we are going to add in a subdivision surface modifier with level of 3 setting. As you can see, it makes the flat parts curve back or bend backwards, and to get rid of this problem I am going to add in a loop cut. For Windows users it should be Alt plus R, sorry for my pronunciation, but for me on Linux it's Control plus R. Just add in a loop here, and let's add in here as well, and let's give it two loops in the middle. For making multiple loops you have to scroll with your mouse. Let's scale it on the y-axis to the sides like this, and it's pretty cool now. Okay, now the next thing I'm going to do is to do the protection on the sides. For this I'm just going to select it, this face loop here, which is going all the way through the model, by pressing Alt right click on face selection mode on one of the edges. for Linux users, if you have some problems, I think that by default it's like a Windows symbol, or I'm not sure what's the name of that key, and Alt GR, and after that press right click. But as you may know, you can make custom shortcuts as I did, so it's Control right click for me to select loop cuts and whatnot. Let's get rid of this selection here, and I don't need this part and this part neither. Let's just duplicate this and move it to the side a little bit, and now I'm going to separate it by pressing P by selecting everything I need to separate, and stepping into edit mode once again, I'm going to extrude this part inwards and create two loops in the middle as before. So we have a nice shape now, and as you can see, the two objects share the same central point, so I can just simply mirror this to the other side. And if you noticed, we can have some problems because this protection part has the same width or thickness as the glass material, so we need to scale it a little bit, and for that I'm just using the scale along normals option. So by you can access this by pressing Alt S and scale the thing, and if I select the glass material, yeah, it should be just fine. It won't have any issues when I render the scene. And as I said before, the only thing you need to do after you have the model ready is to link in materials, but before that I'm going to actually save this, and let's do another blend, and we need to create the legs as well, and I'm going to just simply duplicate this face here, extrude it, and have it like this. Alright, I'm going to create I didn't select the whole face, well that's because this option here is in or applied, so I have to select things manually. Or the other thing you can do if you encounter something like this is to switch to wireframe mode, and if you select anything in this mode, then it will be actually selected, because as you can see, I can't really select the parts that are behind the actual geometry, right? So let's just select this face, extrude it here, and I think that this should be almost alright. Now let's just keep these loops in line. Then I'm going to create a small blob or whatever, so a small spherical thing here, and move this to the side, and I notice that we have two edge loops here which are not needed for the legs, and this is starting to look good for me. Let's just move this down, right, okay, this shouldn't bother the use of the table, or yeah, so the legs shouldn't bother you using the top of the table. And another thing I might do, but I don't think that it is necessary now, I think that this surface is pretty flat, so you can use it as a table. So I imagine this table in real life like this, so I can have things on here and here and maybe a chair here. So this is a coffee desk or coffee table or whatnot. I kinda like the new shapes, and I think that I will leave this right here. And now the only thing we need is to link in materials and lighting setup and the node setup. So under file, look for link or press Ctrl Alt O and find the blend file I am providing. You should be able to find it in the description of this video. And under material you can see there are three materials here. Link in all of them. You are able to link everything at once if you select them, but I like to, as it seems, I like to link them by one by one. And now I'm going to link in the lamp group. You can link the lamps in one by one as well. If you select the lamps directory here, you can see there are all the lamps. And the last thing I need is the node 3, this vintage feel node 3 I've made up for the scene. And if you notice, the table or desk or whatever is a bit too big for this light setup, so I'm just going to scale it down a little bit like this. And let's check, where is my camera? Here it is. Okay, let's set the camera to a pose like this. Alright, let's save. Now I'm just going to assign some materials, simply selecting them from the drop down menu. Glass for the middle part and plastic for the other two. And the third material is going to be used for the ground plane floor shadow. This material is only rendering the shadows of the table, so you will get a nice studio feel or studio feel for your render. And this can be achieved by ticking this option here down here under shadow. If you want to look into these materials, reverse engineering is advised, so feel free to look into the blend files. And even though this glass material is not perfect, I probably should have made the Z offset a bit higher. Anyway, I won't bother with that now. So this can be tweaked further than it is. And if we render this now, we will get a pretty nice render already, but it misses all the shadows, and that is because we don't use ambient occlusion at all, nor environment lighting. I'm going to enable those settings now. Before that, let's check the transparency and set the depth to 4. And fall off a little lower. Okay, it shouldn't be. Or it should be good. And I'm not sure about Z offset, but let's read it quickly. Gives faces an artificial offset. Alright. We are not using Z transparency, so it doesn't matter at all, because I'm using ray trace for this material. This should be cool now. And what was I going to do? Alright, setting an ambient occlusion and environment lighting. This can be found under world settings, and basically this will create even lighting for your scene and generate fake shadows. but we have to tune this down to around 0.7 and 0.75 and crank the samples up to 10 or even higher, and this should give a nice touch for the scene or to the scene. But before I render it, let me turn the resolution down just for the sake of this tutorial. I don't really want to render for hours, and let's tune the percentage down to 80 as well. Alright, this is starting to look good, and we have the shadows as well. You can see the nice little nice subtle self shadow on this layer, and there should be some shadow on the ground as well. Yes, this here. Alright, I won't finish this render because we missed the composition. For that, I am just going to save this quickly and switch to composition, use nodes, use a backdrop, even though it's not visible because I didn't do a full render. So let's just see the render result here. And I am just going to link in the group I've, or add in the group I've linked in. And as you can see, it gives the photo a nice touch. I could show this to you, I think. What did I do? I've just made some simple modifications for the light and the shadow values, and of course a little bit of color balance, and I gave the output a little bit of more contrast overall. So it's not a big deal. It's, if you want to look into this, you can see the settings in the material.blend file, but for now let's just render the scene finally and let's see how it looks. It could use more anti-aliasing as well as some more subdivision levels, but I think that for this tutorial it's all good. This can take a while, as you can see, and this is because we have lots of polygons and we have a what is it? Ray trace material, or I think that's the correct name. Alright. Yeah, so we have ray tracing in this scene, and that makes the render a bit slower. Anyway, this shouldn't be a problem if we have cycles. So I think that this is it. This concludes it all, and feel free to comment or ask anything about this tutorial. I hope that you liked it, and I think, yeah, this is it. Goodbye.